Here's our lesson on exact and approximate numbers. When we do technical computations or calculations for physical quantities, it's going to involve using both exact and approximate numbers, so we're going to need a definition of those. First, let's take a look, though, at some examples of physical quantities that we might encounter in BCS. Example, we have a nursery that's shipping 20 maple trees, of which the shortest was measured as 0.8 meters and the tallest as 3.1 meters. So we'll need to know whether the 20, the 3.1, and the 0.8 are exact or approximate. We might be using a definition that an inch is being defined as 2.54 centimeters. Maybe we're doing some type of construction. We need to know this. So we'll have to know whether the 2.5 and the 1 are exact or approximate. We might have time, and we have a definition that 60 minutes is an hour. We also might be dealing with a particular machine, and we know that that machine has 5 parts. We might be doing some design with a parking lot, and we've counted the number of parking spaces, and it came out to 60. We may have measured the room dimensions, or a room dimension, and it came out as 3.7 meters and 2.9 meters. Or we may have a cylindrical storage tank, but we have the dimensions of, the radius is 1.5 meters, and the height is 2.0 meters. So before we do any calculations with any of these numbers, we really should know which ones are exact and which ones are approximate. So let's take a look at some definitions for exact quantities and approximate quantities. So exact quantities are going to be those physical quantities that we can either count or we define. Approximate quantities are going to be those physical quantities that we either measure or that we have calculated from measured values. So from our examples, our 20 trees, well, we counted them, so the 20 is exact. Our definition of an inch, 1 inch is 2.54 centimeters, so the 1 and the 2.54 are considered exact. Our definition of an hour, 60 minutes is 1 hour, so the 60 and the 1 are considered exact. In our machine, we counted 5 parts, so we counted that, so the 5 is an exact quantity. Our 60 parking spaces, again, we counted it, so the 60 is an exact quantity. For the approximate ones, well, we measured the tree heights. The smallest was 0.8 meters and the large was 3.1 meters, so since we measured those are considered approximate quantities. Our room dimensions are 3.7 meters by 2.9 meters. Again, we measured those dimensions, so those are considered approximate quantities. We could calculate the area of this room that we have the dimensions for, so area is length times width, so the 3.7 meters times the 2.9 meters comes out to 10.73 square meters, and the 3.7 is approximate, the 2.9 is approximate because we measured those, and since we did this calculation with measured values, that is also considered an approximate quantity. We can also calculate the volume of water that we put in our cylindrical storage tank. So the volume is given by the formula pi times the radius squared times the height. So our radius, the measured radius, was 1.5 meters. Our measured height was 2.0 meters. We know that these measured heights are considered approximate. And then this calculation, the final answer, 14.137 meters cubed, that will also, since it's a calculation from measured values, be considered approximate.